Once upon a time, there was a girl named Snow White, whose skin was as white as the snow. Her father was a kind man, but her stepmother was a mean and busy woman. The queen had a magical mirror and would always ask, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?"
"You, my queen, are the most fairest of them all."
The mirror was not only magical, it was very honest. One day, something surprising happened.
"Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?"
"The white, my queen, is the most beautiful among them all."
The news struck the queen, but after the entail shock, she decided to fix the problem, as cruel as her heart.
The queen called the cure to kill Snow White and take her heart back to her as proof.
The guard took Snow White to the woods and killed a wild pig instead, and gave the heart to the queen.
The queen was happy to hear that Snow White was dead, and she turned down to the mirror.
"Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?"
"Snow White, my queen, is the loveliest among them all."
The queen now knew that the girl was still alive. "I will have to kill Snow White on my own."
At the time, Snow White was wandering alone in the woods until she came to a small cottage.
It looked so unreal with its tiny windows and small door and chimney.
"I wonder who lives there. I think I will go in and take a look around."
And Snow White went inside. Everything was tiny. The table was set for 7 seats. Snow White was hungry. She decided to have a bite of each meal and sip of each cup, so that she didn't leave anyone without a meal.
"I'm so tired, I think I'll go find a bed to sleep in."
It was not long before the house owners got home. There were 7 dwarves who worked in the mines every day.
The dwarves were surprised when they saw Snow White. They let her sleep.
When she woke up, Snow White told them her story. When they heard all that she had to tell, the dwarves gathered for a meeting. They decided to let her stay and live with them.
The next day, they left to work and warned Snow White to be very careful and not to open the door to strangers.
Back at castle, the queen dressed herself as an old woman. "I am going to take a poisonous apple and find the Snow White."
Soon, the queen found Snow White hiding in the cottage.
"Sweet apples, I have melody. Won't you buy some?"
"The landlord told me not to open the door to strangers."
"Ah, you needed to open the door. Here, try this big red apple." When Snow White bit the apple, she fainted on the floor. Lifeless, and the queen ran away. When the dwarves found her, they saw she was dead.
They tried everything they could to save her, but they couldn't bring her back to life.
The dwarves cried and wept for days. They laid her on a bed of rose petals in a crystal coffin and started off to the mountains to take the coffin there, so that they can see her beautiful face every day when they were going to back and from mines.
On their way to the mountains, a stranger met them. He was riding a beautiful black horse, and when he saw Snow White, he fell in love with her. "Where are you going with this beauty?"
The dwarves told him that they were going to the mountains to lay the coffin there, so that they would go and visit Snow White every day.
"Let me help you with this. You can put the coffin on the horse back." The dwarves lifted the bed of the roses and all started for the mountains. On their way, the horse stumbled over a bump, and at the moment Snow White coughed out the poisonous bite.
When she woke up, the prince and dwarves couldn't experience their happiness.
"An old woman gave me a poisonous apple and then I ate it and fainted on the floor. I think it was my stepmother, the queen."
"My princess, if you become my wife, I will protect you day and night from your stepmother." At the time, the queen was standing in front of her magical mirror.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
Snow White, my queen, is still the fairest of them all. She survived the poison and she is getting married to a prince who saved her.
The queen couldn't bear the news and died. And Snow White and the prince got married and lived happily ever after.
The